Right now on the hotline, we have Diego Lima, who triumphed for Team Edgar last night, defeating Tim Williams by rear naked choke in the second round. What a comeback win. Diego, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you guys doing?
Excellent. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, and thank you for that fight, man. I was just saying, last night's fight between you and Tim was the reason that you don't miss the show. It's the reason you have to watch The Ultimate Fighter, because that was one of the most entertaining fights I've seen in a long time. Thank you, Diego.
Oh, you're welcome. You know, we just put it out there. You know, we had no choice. We couldn't. There was no fighting safe there. You know, we had to go at it. That's the way to go.
I was very curious if, you know, you were going through some adversity in that fight. You had some struggles in the first round. Was there any doubt in your mind that you would make it out of that round?
No, I knew I would make it out of that round. You know, I have black belts on my back all the time, you know, but, you know, I just try to keep my composure, you know. I was just like, all right, second round, you know, that's all I was thinking, because you were so late in the round, and I just had to survive, you know. I didn't want to make any stupid explosion and, you know, leave myself open. So that's why I just held back, you know. It's like, so, but, you know, it is, I had no doubt, you know. It was just, I was ready for it, and, you know, I've had black belts on my back before, but that was the thing, just keeping a composure, you know, and not, because some people would have tried to explode so much, and then, boom, get caught in something. So I knew I lost the first, you know. I knew I had another round, so that's how I went about it.
And over on your professional career, you're 8-1. You've never been finished. So I think, like you said, you've had black belts on your back a lot. But one thing I'm curious about also is, when you're in that kind of fight, when you're in that kind of war, did you at all hear Team Penn chanting ole, ole, ole while you're in there?
I did. When he was on my back, I did. I did it one time, and then, like, I just kind of looked over there, and I'm like, okay, you guys just wait, you know? I got one more round, so I did. I still heard him when he was on my back, because I look over there, and I hear them really yell, and I'm like, oh, my God, you know, I got to get out of here. It's part of the game, you know. That's what they do to get on our heads, you know, but I'm just glad I got to, you know, quiet them down a little bit.
You vowed to do it, man, and you stuck by your word, so props to you for that. How much did you hear Frankie also coaching you through that first round, trying to, there were times there, he's like, put your back to the floor. I mean, was that
something? Yeah, no, I heard everything. I heard everything he was saying, but I just had a blank on that round. I don't know what happened. Like, I was just not there, you know. It was just, I don't know if it's because I fought 2 weeks before, you know. I don't know what it was. Like, I could hear them, but it just wouldn't go. Like, my body, my mind was in it, but it's just my body wouldn't do what I wanted to do. And it was just about surviving, you know. My mind wasn't there. Like, I couldn't wake up. And then, it was rough. It sucks, because I knew what I was supposed to do, and it didn't happen, you know. And I just want to make sure that never happens again.
Well, yeah, I saw your Twitter this morning. You seemed a little disappointed with what happened in that first round, and you had vowed.
I was disappointed in that fight, period. You know, the only thing I'm happy about is the W, but I'm not even going to watch that fight again, tell you the truth. That was the worst performance of my life. You know, I looked sloppy on the feet. I just looked sloppy everywhere, you know. It's just, for me, it didn't look like a UFC caliber fight, you know. That's why I'm mad at myself, and, you know, that's why I'm killing myself at the gym today, you know. It's just, got to get better, and, you know, I won't have a performance like that again. You know, even though I got the W, that was just not me. You know, even my stand-up is not like that. You know, everything. It's just, I don't know what it was. You know, it's just, I don't know.
Well, you know what? I'm going to say that's pretty good for fight fans, because if that was a performance that you're not happy with, I can't wait to see what you got for the rest of your career, because you are going to excite quite a few fans, Diego. Let me tell you that, because last night's fight, like I said, it had everything that you want from an MMA fight. And you talk about how you're in the gym today, training hard. You train with some animals down there in Atlanta. But I want to know about your time here in Vegas. What did you get out of working with the guys you did and the coaches like Frankie and Henzo and the guys that he brought in?
Oh, it was something else, man, because I usually stay just here in Atlanta to train. You know, I go to Coconut Creek, Florida as well, and American Top Team over there for some parts of my camp, but that was just a whole different experience, man. It was amazing what Frankie brought to the table, you know, like That guy trains three times a day, even when he's not in camp, man. He's an animal, you know. He's always improving. He's always finding a way to get better, you know. He never stops, man. He was amazing. Like, he brought his whole team with him. You know, I got to work with, what, five different stand-up coaches, and it's like four Brazilian black belts. It's like Hansel Gracie, you know. It was just an amazing experience, man. The guy, Frankie, like, we owe him props, you know. Like, it's just amazing for him to do what he did, you know, bring his whole team. And even the guys that lost in the fight, you know, like Todd Monahan, you know, he lost his fight, but he left out of there like a completely different fighter. Like, he got so much better being there, you know. Like, everyone, like Hector, man, all these guys, you know, they came in and we learned so much from it. Like, everybody left a different fighter, you know. There's not even one single fighter that can say, you know, oh, I didn't learn anything being on that show, you know. Everybody left a great fighter, you know. They came in good, but, man, left a great fighter, you know. Like, they were awesome, man. Best coaching staff I've seen in a while, you know. He had something for everything. He had a wrestling coach, jiu-jitsu, MMA, whatever it was, you know, he had it. So it was an amazing experience, man, and that just put so much spike in my career, you know. It's like, man, I'm ready for anything now, you know, just being there. Fighting in front of Dana, fighting in front of these guys, I'm like, I think I'm ready for the big show, you know. I'm ready to go. So it was an amazing experience. No way to explain it.
You sound totally fired up, and I love that. I love that kind of passion. Tell me a little bit about how much you're talking about the role models here, how much your brother, Douglas, has played a part in basically showing you the ropes from an early age when you guys have been, you know, training and moving up the career. He's an MMA champion. How much has he been an influence?
Oh, you know, he's the biggest part of it, you know. It's just looking up to him always, you know. When we both fought in the MFC, you know, I had my first fight on TV, you know, and that's when he won the belt. So that's the first time, you know. And then after that, you know, he won the Bellator championship. So, you know, it's amazing. Always just looking up to him. We always train together. And it's been like that forever because, like, my first coach, Junior Asuncion, you know, he was my brother's trainer. So I always just watched him, and he's like, you need to train. And then I started, you know, and then Junior ended up moving back to Brazil. So we started training with Jucão, you know, and that was the same way, you know. Jucão made him a champion, made him win all the championships. And I, you know, I was there with him, you know. I was training, and he's like, you're next, you know, just wait for your time. You're really young. So that's where that maturity level comes from, you know. I've been watching him, you know, it just takes time, you know. My brother's had, what, 30-something professional fights, so. He's been in a while, and he just said, just take your time, you know. Take your time. Your time will come. You're still young, so I'm just enjoying it, you know. It's just been a blessing.
Well, and that's awesome. And by the way, congratulations to your brother for picking up that title. Very impressive performance. And, you know, you talk about your training partners and training down in Atlanta. You being on the Ultimate Fighter right now, your brother winning that championship. And I just heard one of your jiu-jitsu coaches just signed to fight in a one-man tournament. Things are going really well for you guys. What's the mentality going around the gym right now? With everything
man, it's going great. You know, my brother with the belt, you know, my trainer just got signed for the 8-man tournament. He's going to have 3 fights tonight, so we're training really hard for that. We got Rafael Asuncion, you know, he's been injured, but he's just now coming back, and he should be in next for that bantamweight title. So, you know, the vibe is really good, man. The vibe is really good, you know. We're training really hard, you know. We're doing everything right, you know. We train hard, and you know, it's just the way it is. It's a great vibe, you know. It's easier, and just everybody at that high level, you know, it's just amazing, man. It's just amazing. Everybody's ready, you know. Whatever comes, we're going to be ready, man. There's a lot more chances to come out of that gym, and we're working really hard.
And for anybody just joining us, we are on the line with Diego Lima, who picked up a very important win last night on the Ultimate Fighter to advance to the semis. Diego, one last question for me right now is, we saw last night on the show, we saw a little animosity brewing between some guys in the house. And you mentioned Hector before, a guy I've seen on Twitter that you've developed a relationship with. Outside of the house, you guys still stay in contact. But it seems you still stay in contact with the guy that everyone seemed to have an issue with, and that is Gutter. You guys buddies, huh?
Oh, yeah, Gutter's the man. You know, he's the general. He He pretty much, man, he brought the excitement to the house. You know, it was the whole time, you know, he's the exciting one, you know, with his talking, and, you know, he can back it up too, man. That's good. He can fight as well, so that's the good thing. He doesn't just talk, you know. But he was awesome, man. He just brought the character to our team, you know. He just made everybody happy, everybody laugh, you know. The blue team didn't like it because they didn't know him really well, you know. We were with him every day, so we know how he is, you know. They just thought he was putting on the front and, you know, just talking. But, hey, that's exactly how he is, man. He doesn't change for anybody, and he doesn't bite his tongue, you know. That's how he is. And if people doesn't want to hear it, you know, they're going to hear it either way. You know, he doesn't play around.
Well, he better not play around. I can't wait to see him fight, because anybody who knows the lines to Titanic as well as he does better be able to fight and back it up.
Exactly. You know, it's awesome, man. His character is amazing, and he's just as good as a fighter as he's a talker, man, you know. So that's somebody to look out for.
All right. Well, my last question is, I've seen that you named your daughter Emily Kate, and in last night's episode we saw that you were trying to come up with the middle name. So I'm curious how you came up with the name Kate.
Kate, that's what my wife had at first, you know. At first because you seem like just like a common name, you know. But as soon as she came out and I saw it, was like, oh, I didn't fit her perfectly, you know. It's just, she's the most amazing thing ever, you know.
Well, congrats.
It was just one we both agreed on, you know. And I told her, I was like, oh, since you were by yourself at home the whole time, you know, I'll let you come up with it. And that's what she did, and I agree with it.
Well, we're really happy for everything that's going on, Diego. You're an uncle, you're a father, you're a family man, and you're a hell of a fighter. Best of luck, you know, with everything.
Oh, thanks a lot, my friend. Thanks a lot. I really appreciate you guys having me on, and, you know, looking forward to the Sammies, man. These guys got some great fighters in the Sammies, and, man, we'll see what happens. I'll just be ready.
All right. Well, we're to wish you all the best of luck in your upcoming run here on The Ultimate Fighter Season 19. Again, that was Diego Lima. He won last night, defeating Tim Williams by submission on The Ultimate Fighter Season 19.